Welcome! Tonight, our concert features our awesome fourth and fifth graders, and they have been working super hard. I'm so proud of them. Can't wait to perform for you. Tonight, they're going to be performing a selection of patriotic songs. So without any further ado, I'm going to ask that you all rise and remove your hats and put your right hand on your heart as our fourth graders lead us in singing our national anthem.
Thank you. mid-1700s, before the Revolutionary War, the song Yankee Doodle was actually used by the British soldiers to make fun of the colonists or Yankees in America. The British were quite amused by the backwoods appearance and behavior of the colonists and sang about it.
Despite the insulting lyrics, the Yankees adopted the song as their own and made up their own lyrics.
They sang with pride and exuberance, and by 1777, it became an unofficial American anthem.
It is even said that it was played at Yorktown when Lord Cornwallis surrendered to George Washington, ending the Revolutionary War.
A great many versions of the lyrics have been created for Yankee Doodle.
Some were written prior to the war, during the war, and afterwards as well.
In fact, new lyrics are being created during the Civil War, almost a century later.
Variations and parodies are still being created even today.
Yankee Doodle remains one of the most well-known, well-loved, popular patriotic songs in America.
Shall fill an honored grave. For glory like the soldier's tomb, and beauty weeps the brave. Joseph Drake. Who kept the faith and fought the fight. The glory theirs, the duty ours. Wallace Bruce. How sleep the brave, who sink to rest, by all their country's wishes blessed, William Collins. Soldier, rest, thy warfare o'er, sleep the sleep that knows not breaking. Dream of battlefields no more, days of danger, nights of waking. Sir Walter Scott. Your silent tents of green we deck with fragrant flowers. Yours has the suffering been, the memory shall be ours. Henry Wadsworth Longfellow.
Thank you. proposition that all men are created equal. Now we are engaged in a great civil war, testing whether that nation or any nation, so conceived and so dedicated, can long endure. We are met on a great battlefield of that war. We have come to dedicate a portion of that field as a final resting place for those who here gave their lives that that nation might live. It is altogether fitting and proper that we should do this. But in a larger sense, we cannot dedicate, we cannot consecrate, we cannot hallow this ground. The brave men, living and dead, who struggled here have consecrated it, far above our poor power to add or detract.
The world will little know, nor long remember what we say here, but it can never forget what they did here. It is for us, the living, rather to be dedicated here to the unfinished work, which they who have fought here have thus far so nobly advanced. It is rather for us to be dedicated here to the great task remaining before us, that from these honored dead, we take increased devotion to that cause for which they gave the last full measurement of devotion, that we here highly resolve that these dead shall not have died in vain, that this nation, under God, shall have a new birth of freedom, and that government of the people, by the people, for the people, shall not perish from the earth.
Thank you.